makulit one. But it's Gavin who's really come out of his shell.
He's really, it's so hard to contain him.
Yeah, but he's also such a character, eh. He's a really active and fun little boy whose sense of humor is also, he has also that sense of humor, so it's fun to be with. And it's nice to grow up with the children. They're able to already express what they feel and tell us what they feel and really converse to us. And, you know, we look forward to many more years of, you know, children's thoughts.
But you know what, for us, for the kids, and I think that's why, you know, we're dubbed the social media family, is because when we don't have any regular shows that you see on TV, it's basically our cameras. And then our cameras, and you know what, doing our commercials, that's pretty much it. So the kids are still growing up, you know, regular kids, they go to school, they're honor students, we go on our trips, everything.
You know what, actually, they don't understand it. They know that people know them, but the capacity of understanding, they don't know. In fact, when Kendra had to do an essay for an exam, and she was asked a question like, what would you do to be able to advocate on something? She couldn't understand the concept that she's in social media and that
she has an impact.
She has an impact because she doesn't understand it yet. And you know what? We try to make our children live, you know, normal lives, right? And they don't feel like they're above everybody else, or, you know, or just because they're known. And we like it to be that way until they really fully understand and they're able to grasp the proper emotions and how to handle it, because we don't want, you know, raising children that might feel that they're entitled or anything. So we try to avoid that. It's nice that they can just enjoy being kids.
You know, number one for me is spending time. You can't discipline your kids without spending time with them. So for me, yeah, I discipline them in terms of, you know, privately, I talk to them, discipline them. But everything after all the disciplining, it's reconciliation and love. Then assurance that I love them and that they shouldn't do the same mistakes again. And then after that, you know, you can see how they are.
Constant reminder, you know, they're children. You can't expect them to get it right away. We've all been kids at one point, diba? And our parents constantly would remind us. So really putting patience there and being consistent. And while being consistent, you should also show them that you are modeling it as well, diba?
Yes, reinforcement every day.
Tell your children one thing and you're doing the other. So be consistent. And I think with Doug, he does. I'm the constant reminder every day, but he's the one who sets his foot down and says already na when it's time to really discipline them, because they don't listen to me na. That is not allowed.
All of our kids, yeah, they sleep beside us.
Yeah.
And they look for us. And,
yes.
And they know I take out my kids on dates. In fact, I'm due for a date with my little boy.
Yeah.
A game date. So that's part of how we want to bring up our kids.
Yeah.
We want to show them each one of them is special.
Yes. And even in our house, we've already spoken to our kasambahays. We tell them never mention that one is more than the other. You know, we don't want to put those things in their heads, right? We don't want to put those things in their heads. And in our family, so far naman our children don't express na parang you love them more than ano, wala, walang ganon. And we're happy. It should stay that way.